A major education milestone today. New Zealand students joining nearly 300 million others around the world and studying for school without leaving home. It's an experiment schools had never planned on. Jill Higgins reports.
Morning.
Today was one for the record books.
It's officially 9 a.m.
A fresh challenge for students.
Can you hear me?
And parents.
How do we make this bigger?
And around the country, it looked like this.
Go away!
Is my bedroom window.
Your kids will be having more of an educational experience than you probably appreciate right now. These are extraordinary times. Don't be too hard on yourselves. They will be learning, even when you may not notice it.
Advice echoed by this principal of a primary school in Hawke's Bay.
Relax into it. Just be a mum, be a dad, and enjoy the time with the kids.
But school is more than maths and English, and he worries about at-risk families.
If there's no opportunities for them to have other connections outside of their bubble, that's always a worry, and making sure that there's enough resources, kai, that go into the whānau.
It's a different challenge for this mum, four boys all in different school years.
Trying to stretch myself, whether it be from doing primary school to high school.
The oldest two have laptops and can't imagine coping without.
Got to write a 1,000-word essay.
I got a couple of meetings going on.
But the youngest have to make do with an iPad or phone.
We have to mix it up, we will.
Most families do have devices, but there are still those without, and even in classes like physical education...
Yeah, morning, guys.
..the difference is huge.
One class looking at nutrition, also their food prep skills, so helping out in the kitchen. And another class is looking at mental health, building resilience.
But too much time on devices also needs avoiding.
And sport, obviously a big thing for a lot of students.
It's the centre of their world, so to have that taken away from them, it's a huge loss. So we're trying to promote being active and creative with balls and games and siblings and parents.
It's all a good start. The next challenge being if parents go back to work before the schools.
I would not hold my breath, let's put it that way. But in saying that, it's up to them to get themselves motivated.
A tough call, but a lesson in itself. Jill Higgins, One News.